Hey everyone, welcome back to NMB Takoyaki Party, episode 50. Episode 50, the big one. Nice even number, you know? We've been doing this for, what?
Half a century.
You know, usually, you know, episode 50, you think, okay, that's like a weekly podcast, you know? So it's like, okay, we're almost like on our 1 year anniversary, you know? But this podcast has been running for a while. Anyway, I'm Matt. I've escaped from one world into another world. I'm stuck in that new world now. And joining me is Geoff.
Hey, how's it going?
I'm doing well. And we are also joined by, for his last appearance on the podcast.
It's the end of the podcast, actually. It's the end of everything.
End of the podcast.
Yeah, no, we're ending everything.
Yep. So yeah, we got some big news to talk about this time.
People might actually believe you though.
Yeah. Who knows? Who can say? Yeah,
who can say?
Keep you guessing.
Yeah.
So we got some big news today. We're gonna talk about some graduations. And
the graduation.
So yeah, Ryan is really upset about the graduation of Odan Mai.
Yeah. God.
Also
damn
known
it.
As Odan Yui's sister.
Yep, yes. Which we should explain that. I think we did it last month because Odan Yuuri actually graduated, and I don't know if we mentioned it, but we said like in the notes is like Odan Mai's sister, and that whole story is like it was I think last year's summer tour.
No, it was eighth anniversary. They had
that too. It was both of them.
Oh, was it both? Okay.
It was both of them. I just remember because it's from the crane game that they had because that's something they started doing last year at the concerts.
Yeah,
and so and you're like, the you only, play the crane game.
You're the only idiot who actually plays it.
Yeah. I just wanted Sayaka or Anchu or whatever, but anyway, it's a crane game, and you win these little, like, I think one of them was, like, yeah, this little, like, figure, like, acrylic figure of a member, and I think at the Sayaka Sonic one, it was, like, buttons? No, or was it, not, 8th anniversary is buttons.
Was
little
it
figures.
Buttons?
Anyway.
Okay.
I think it was buttons, maybe?
Yeah.
I think the Sayaka song might have been, like, Sayaka costumes.
I don't remember.
I don't know. Anyway, it's, like, randomly selected members, these little figure things, and they're really tiny, so you can't really make out who is who. And also, even my encyclopedic knowledge of NMB members, I had trouble knowing who they were. So, I'm like, I post a picture, and I'm like, who's this? And I think it's Andy. He's like, oh, that's Odan Yui's sister. And then I had to like Google it. who's Odan Yui's sister? Cause I'm pretty sure people on like Mercari or Yahoo Auctions or whoever, like, they wouldn't appreciate if I wrote like Odan Yui no Onei-chan figure. So that's my story about Odan Mai.
That was it. That's it, basically. Yeah. That's all you need to know about Odan Mai.
Yep. She announced her graduation.
Yeah, do you have anything to say, Geoff?
Well, so
you're the 100 yen chan connoisseur here.
Yeah. So, I mean, she's one of those members who's a veteran, been around a long time, and she's has a really established character and is good in MCs and all those shows like You Got the NMB that I love to watch and Nathan loves to watch. Shout out to Nathan. But so actually, what more than, you know, I like her, but not so much that I would be so really saddened by her graduation. But the fact that it happened immediately after Yuuri's announcement really hit me.
What? What?
What? What announcement?
What announcement?
Wait, what?
Spoilers.
What?
Spoilers.
Oh, shit. Ryan's. Ryan, calm down. It's going to be okay.
It's not going to be okay. That's the problem.
Anyway.
But yeah, so that's just like, so with a big graduation like Yuuri, you kind of expect there would be a pause in all the graduation announcements for a while. And after having so many over the past few months, I was hoping, okay, the like silver lining is that we'll have a little bit of stability. But then.
Yeah.
Like, so it was. So on top of that, Maichi announced at a Team End show the first one after Yuuri announced. So, and Chihi made this super long speech about how she's worried about Team N in the future, but she's hoping that the new members coming up will, you know, have a chance to shine. And then Maichi comes out.
And then Maichi announces.
Yeah. And it seemed like Chihi didn't even know, which I'm not sure if she did. I haven't asked.
It sounded like she didn't know. Based on her reaction when Maichi announced, it looked like she didn't know.
Yeah, she kind of pretty fucked up. Had to turn on she was on the stage and had to like turn and look and see who was saying like, "Oh, I'm graduating."
Yeah.
So
that's terrible.
Yeah. So and then so Maichi also is what also kind of made me feel almost a little bitter is that she even said she's not participating in 9th anniversary. So she said she's going to pursue like aromatherapy or like what's it called? Like yoga and all those like health and
she has aromatherapy certification, right?
Yeah.
I think she does. Yeah.
All the fake science stuff. Chiropractor.
Yeah.
Hey, chiropractor.
Smell this. It'll make you feel good.
Yeah, you need your mystic stones to make your back feel better.
I think there was a time when in Handshake, she was actually doing aromatherapy in her lane.
Yeah, she set up like candles and stuff.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
You didn't hear about this, man?
No.
I remember like people talking about it. It's like, oh my god, I was like right beside Maichi's lane and like there was some weird smell coming from it.
It was all dark and smoky. It's like blackout curtains around her booth.
you hear Bob Marley music coming out. Not that kind of smell.
It's not that kind of smell.
Just playing on her phone, yeah.
But yeah, so she said she is not joining in 9th anniversary because she wants to use that time to like prepare for her next like job as a aromatherapist or whatever.
Yeah, and she's the first member who announced that has said that she's not going to do the 9th anniversary.
Yeah. A lot of the graduations from the past month, like Rinachi and Sararan, they're still sticking around past 9th anniversary. I kind of see it as like one last chance for them to be celebrated by the fans.
Mm.
But Maichi is like in a real hurry to get out.
Yeah. Even her sister's staying?
No, her sister left.
She's
today,
gone.
Today, tomorrow, something like that. I think it's tomorrow.
Yeah, real soon.
Oh,
sorry. No, there's no, there's no point of reference for that date. It's on Thursday, I think.
Some Thursday.
Some 19th. Thursday. Whenever you're listening to this, that Thursday.
Some Thursday in mid-September of the year 2019.
Yes. Anyways, yes. Odan Yui's gone. And Odan Mai is gone. So we went from having two Odans to having zero.
That's like the Chinese proverb or something, right?
Probably, yeah. Run after two hairs and you end up with none or something like that?
Yeah, something like that.
That's terrible.
A bird in the hand is better than two in the bush.
Anyways, moving on. So I think, have you ever been to Maichi's Handshake? Any of you been to Maichi?
I did for like one ticket.
How was it?
It's just the regular like introductory like, "Hi, I'm from America." She's like kind of fish. I mean, she's kind of a fisher, obviously. That's her whole character. So it was fine like that. It's not my type, but I mean, I think she was fine at that.
My first ever Nambashiki was Maichi.
Ah.
That was a really long time ago. I think it was like Kamonegix or something, or Boku na Yurika.
I assume you got it because she was on the same team as Yuuri.
Yeah.
So B team.
Of course. No, back then it wasn't per team. It was per group. Because they had to mix Sayaka and Milky up. They had to separate them.
Well, that's why they did the shuffle.
Yeah. Because strong.
Yeah. I don't think I've gone to her personally, but I think she might have been like in the gauntlet of like one of the, I think like last year's like in special handshake where it's like all the generations were in one booth. I think so.
Oh.
I went to the fourth gen booth.
Did you?
Oh. Yeah. So yeah, I might have seen her.
Wait, why did you?
I think I was in there for like Nagisa and like Yamarina.
Oh yeah, I thought Nagisa.
And I think I was like Rika T.
Oh, I should tell my Yamarina story later.
Yeah, we'll get to that.
I think that can count in the live report.
Yep.
Yeah. It's the only good thing that happened on that day.
Anyway.
Yeah, so good luck to her. Good luck to her on her aromatherapy career, and you know. I mean, she's been here a while. So like she's at the point where you're not really surprised at anyone leaving anymore.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And she's
more surprising that she like grants her graduation after her younger sister.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she even tweeted. She even tweeted for her sister. Saying like, oh, you know, she has school and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
But she's also 25, right? And
she was the oldest NMB member.
Some people are saying like NMB has a like soft cap that you have to graduate by 25.
Yeah, that's the joke. I don't think that's true though. If Sayaka had said that, oh, I want to stay, then they would totally let her stay.
But I mean, like, practically speaking, 25 is probably a good time for you to think about your next step if you're an idol.
Yeah.
Yeah, unless you're Yukirin. She's 29 or something.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So that's Odamai. So, God, so Ryan's really upset about that announcement.
Yeah, it's like couldn't sleep for 3 days,
yelling at us in our line group, all depressed and stuff.
Yeah, it wasn't because of Iceborne.
Yeah, I mean that's also a problem. As for other piece of news, I guess some other member, I don't know. Ota Yuuri, is she like Kenkyuusei or something? You know,
one of those Otas in NMB.
Yeah, like Riona's sister or something. I don't know. So this is like the big news we're gonna talk about. It's the big news. Saved it best for last or best for second. You know, first is the worst, second is the best. Plan this all out. You know, plan this all out for Ryan. So, Ota Yuuri announced her graduation at the... this is actually interesting. Like, the same pattern as Sayaka 1 year ago.
Yeah, exact same pattern at the Tokyo leg of the national
Tokyo tour. Leg of the NMB tour.
It was this tour one. Was
also streamed.
Yes.
Which none of the other shows are streamed.
Yes.
I believe. Yeah. Which... So now, like, if it happens again next year, you know, okay, they do a Tokyo leg, the tour.
Who's graduating this time?
That means, you know, like, Miru or, you know, Akarin or someone's probably going to announce their grad.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Should totally not do the Tokyo leg of a tour anymore.
Just cancel it.
Yes, cancel it.
Do a Saitama instead.
Yeah, make it easier for me to get there.
It's going to be like, with your luck, Geoff, it's going to be like on the other side of Saitama. Like
yeah, actually, it probably was easier for me to get to Shibuya.
Right? Rather than like Omiya or something.
But yeah, anyway. Yeah, yes. This was a real, real gut punch.
Well, welcome to the last episode of Takoyaki Party.
So I think this is kind of like karma.
Why?
So like, I think like 2 episodes ago, you know, I was all like, depressed, like, oh my Oshi announced her graduation, I'm so upset. And then I introduced Ryan, right? And now we have Ryan, whose Oshi hasn't announced her graduation yet.
Probably so it's your fault.
Yeah, I
it's
guess
your
so.
Fault.
I'm like the Grim Reaper of
but piece that
of
wasn't, shit, man. That, but for you, it wasn't even NMB, it was Lala, right?
Hey, we won't talk about that.
That your other podcast, like Miso Katsu Party?
Yeah.
Miso Katsu Party.
Sunshine Ferris Wheel Party. Anyway, yeah. Anyway, yeah, so actually, I think I was busy playing World of Warcraft when this announcement happened. So I didn't see it until like 3 hours later. And then I'm like, oh shit, Ryan. That was like breaking news or whatever. And I was like, wait, you were at that show in person.
You should have seen like Andy's first message. He didn't even say you graduated. He said, well, I guess we're never seeing Ryan anymore.
Also true.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess we can kind of combine this with the talk about the whole set up the situation, because Ryan and I were at the Tokyo show.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yeah, the concert was really good. Like, it was all like a lot of classic NMB songs. It was a lot of fun, even though we had really bad seats. But then in the encore, after like 3 songs, yeah, suddenly Yuuri, you know, says those words. You know, I have an announcement to make, and you know then what it's gonna be.
And you don't know. It's gonna be like, oh, I'm launching my own brand.
It's yeah,
I'm doing makeup.
Like, would they do it at do something like that?
That seems like it'd be like a VTR thing.
Yeah,
because that's how Ocarina did hers.
Yeah, well, yeah, there was no monitor.
Yeah. But yeah, at that point, yeah, I was
whose
like...
Whose fault was that?
NMB management.
Yep. NHK Hall also.
Yeah, well, that's true. Terrible place to have a concert. You should tear it down.
It's cursed now.
Wait, last year was also NHK Hall?
Yeah. No, it was
Nakano. No, it was Nakano.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So actually, NHK Halls was like a step above. It's a better place to have a concert, but, you know. I will miss it because their meteor is going to hit it soon. No, anyways, sorry for the derail. Just go ahead, Geoff.
Yeah, but yeah, I mean, as soon as she said, like, I'm graduating from NMB, I was like, I just turned to Ryan. He was just like frozen. And I was like,
dropped
oh,
his Uchiwa.
Crap.
Well, I had run it in my head like probably 100 times, I guess, like how I would have reacted. So even before, right? Like, oh, I wonder how I would react if, so especially when like Sayaka graduated, I was like, oh, I wonder how I would react if it was Yuuri. Oh, it's gonna be like 5 years from now.
Yeah.
And then, but it was like not what I expected, like how I would react. It was like I was weirdly looking at it really, really objectively. It's like, oh, she's announcing her graduation. Huh. Huh. Wonder what's gonna happen. Like, what am I gonna do with all this free time I have?
So no, seriously, money that I have now too.
Yeah, so that's seriously what was running around in my head. It's like, oh, yeah. Okay.
Because, like, I think, so, I mean, I've been through the graduation, obviously not as, it wasn't as shocking as Yuuri. Because, like, I mean, Yuuri, she's still really young and was obviously had so much, like, still had a lot of potential. She was, like, this is, yeah, way before anyone expected. So I imagine, yeah, you kind of just like, you know, instantly jump into like denial mode on the five steps of acceptance.
Mm.
Or like, I don't know, try to like find something rational that your mind can latch onto.
Try to find a good out of it or some kind of...
Yeah.
Some kind of alternative way of looking at it.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't think there's any like positive way to look at this. There's like, are we starting talking about the fallout, or are we still gonna go through?
Yeah, kind of. Like for me, my immediate reaction was like, "Oh my god, what's gonna happen to NMB now?"
Yeah, I think that was what everyone's reaction. Like, I was telling you guys off the air is that, rather than like people being surprised that Yuuri quit, which is like really, really shocking, right? It's like, oh my god, that's terrible. And it's more that like what it represents, because Yuuri is really young. She's 19, and
she's like 6 years left.
Yeah, she's 6 years from the 25 limit. No, cut off. So
the expiration date or whatever.
She's 6 years younger than when Sayaka graduated. She's 3 years younger than like any other member of Quintet. And she's like 2 years younger than Miru. I think three. So
and she's 11 years younger than me. So you had to put in all the...
Well, no one cares about you,
man. Doxing yourself.
Yeah. So, it's not... Like, Yuuri was supposed to be, like, the future of NMB, right? Like, even more than Miru. Because, like, Yuuri would be... Like, even when Miru's gone, like, Yuuri would still be there because of her age. Like, she was the one that was supposed to, like, lead...
Balance to the force.
Yeah, bring balance to the force.
She was the chosen one.
Didn't have the high ground though.
Yep. So well, more on that later.
Yeah. So, like what she represented, right, was like, she was gonna be the future of NMB, but I guess that's not what she thought of herself as. Because whenever you talk to her, it becomes very obvious that she sees herself as, like, very old. Like, she's... Even in her announcement, she says, I've been with NMB for 7.5 years. Which is mind-blowing, right? She's 19 and she's been with NMB for 7.5 years. She started really young. And from her point of view, like, she wants to, like, pass it on to the... She wants to, like, run after her own dreams. Like, okay, let's talk about her speech. Whatever. She said that she really loves NMB, but within herself, she realized that, like, NMB is a comfortable place for her. Mm. And that terrified her. She doesn't want a comfortable place because, you know, she wants to grow. And so she decided, like, okay, I have to leave because I have to grow. Because I'm too comfortable with NMB. Which, I don't know. I guess you have to respect that.
Mm-hmm.
And she did say that, I'm going to stay in show business. So, even if you go to her in handshakes or whatever, right? She doesn't see it as any kind of, like, goodbye. From her point of view, because hey, I'm still gonna be around. Obviously, it's like completely different if you're a fan, right? But like,
yeah.
that's what makes it hard, even like for her fans, because you have to like balance this, like, oh, I'm so sad that she's leaving, but then she doesn't expect you to be sad. I mean, she does, obviously, she's not stupid, but like her message to everyone is always like, well, I'm still gonna be here, I'm gonna try to like do events and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it what I felt was like the balance, like it's there's always that balance of being selfish as a fan wishing that your favorite members would stay forever, or like you would be able to meet them a lot, but they have to move on and grow and graduate eventually. And so, like, especially for someone like Yuuri, I don't know, I guess she's always been kind of, she's never been a typical idol. Like, she's always had, like, her own interest in, like, I guess recently in acting and then, like, in other things, like, in the past photography, for example. And then when she said, like, oh, she doesn't want to be in NMB because it's too comfortable and she wants to keep growing, that's kind of like, yeah, was like a kind of a shot, like a big reminder, like, or like, I don't know, a big realization. Maybe she wasn't, even though we wanted her to be the center, maybe she wasn't meant to be.
Yeah, she even mentioned in her mobame after the graduation is that she says like, it's everything I said in my speech was true, but another reason is that I've given up on becoming center.
Yeah.
And like, so I guess for her, right, if you're not going for the center, then why are you even here?
Right. So she's very hard on herself, right? Has really high standards.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. She's very, very hard on herself. She thinks she's terrible at everything.
Just like Sayaka.
No, not really. I think Sayaka thinks Sayaka she's good at
certain
things.
Like, kind of like, you know, insecure. She's always been kind of insecure with like...
Yeah, but Sayaka's the type like where she's insecure in the sense that she wants you to praise her. Yuuri is insecure in the sense that if you praise her, she thinks you're lying. Right, so it's kind of different.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think I'm too close to this. So what do you think, Matt?
Well, I'm kind of like, I've been kind of numb to graduations over the last few years as like my Oshis have graduated, you know, one by one. So like I've I think I probably felt the same going through the same situation as you, like when Imichi announced her graduation like 2 years ago. It's like same thing. It was like, yeah, like what? And especially because like, I had that similar situation where like, you know, I've been close in terms of like, you know, handshake conversations, you know, getting to know each other a lot better. So definitely like when you lose the opportunity to go see her, it definitely sucks. But yeah, for Yuuri, I basically I'll just like just feel in for you. I'm feeling bad for Ryan.
I got so
that's the only nice thing I ever said to Ryan.
Oh my god. I got so many messages from like people like I haven't talked for a while.
It's like when it's your birthday on Facebook, you get all these random like messages from like, hey, happy birthday, from random people you don't ever talk to, but they follow you on Facebook.
Yeah, so these are like Ota friends that like I used to know. And like whatever reasons they've already like quit or whatever, I just got them. Hey, are you okay? No, what? Why do you think I'm okay? It's like, yeah. So going back to like what it means for NMB, right? It's like really, really negative in the sense that like, if NMB can't even keep like basically their number two, right? Who is not old, and who is, I mean, for example, like when Milky quit, it was like, oh, well, she was number two, but it was like you could justify it by saying that, well, she's been here a while, right? And yeah, like the reason she's not number one is because, and the reason she's number two is because like someone more deserving is number one.
No one's
ever gonna deny that.
That wasn't
right?
A jab.
Yeah, it wasn't a jab at all. It was very calm statement of fact.
Yeah, I mean it's like same with like with Nana. You know, it's like okay, you have like your three pillars or whatever. So
yeah, well, Nana was kind of surprising in the sense that she graduated early. Right, you know that Suzu has been like a member longer than Nana.
Really? What? Wow.
Yeah, because Nana graduated 2014, which would make her like 3 to 4 years in NMB
in the group.
Yeah,
yeah, and Suzu's like 3.5, I guess, or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And fifth gen started 2016.
Yeah.
2017. It's coming up to 3 years.
No, it's past 3 years now.
Yeah, I mean, Suzu's going to be here a while.
17, 18. Yeah.
Yeah. So, Yeah, so Nana was kind of surprising, but yeah, even then you're still like, oh, okay, well, she wants to try it. She wants to try new things, right? And she's gonna be like this big variety star or whatever.
Mm.
And then even with Milky, like, oh wow, she's been here a while. When she graduated, she was there for like 5 years.
Yeah,
five or six. I think it was six.
And, she left. I mean, she like hinted at graduation for quite a while before.
Yeah, so it wasn't really surprising.
She was like pulling out of like activities and stuff.
Yeah,
all the time.
So even with Jonishike and Fu-chan, it wasn't that surprising because I mean it was surprising, but it wasn't really like, oh my god,
right?
Because they weren't, number one, like they weren't really that high. Well, I guess Fu-chan was high up, but still, like with Fu-chan, you felt like she reached her peak.
Mm-hmm.
And considering her age, right? She's older than Miru. And Keiichi is older than Miru too. And then, considering their positions, right? It's like, oh, okay. Well, makes sense. Like, I can compare, like, how shocking this is. Like, how big of a blow this is to NMB with, like, Shu's graduation.
Yeah. That's the one everyone
said. That was a gut punch. Yeah. Because she was considered like the future of NMB, right? She was like the Jisedai 6, the next generation 6.
Yeah.
She was part of that.
All that single with all the W centers.
Yeah. Oh my god, how many are left? Oh god, Miru and Nagisa are going to be the only ones left.
Yeah.
So
Fu-chan was
it
was Fumiru.
Yeah, Fumiru, Yuri Ripon, and Nagishu.
Yeah.
So for whatever reasons, like almost all of them are gone. Right. So with Shu, right? But I'm trying to look at this objectively, right? I think like Yuri's graduation is even more of a gut punch than Shu's graduation because Yuri had actually achieved the next gen, like the center, like. The next center.
She was on her way to getting it. Yeah.
Yeah, she was on her way to getting center, right? Like everyone already like acknowledged that like it was a matter of time when she would get the center.
Yeah, like Miru is like a transition center.
Yes, you said that, not me. But I think some people look at Yuri as a transitional center actually because she's the one in between
like fifth gen or whatever.
Yeah. She was the one in between first and fifth gen, right? Like, she's 19, yeah. Miru's 22, and then Ayan's 16.
Yeah. So, for me, yeah, that's one of the big things. Like, yeah, now that Yuri's gone, that is just going to make the transition to the next gen even more abrupt. And then, as an NMB fan who started in, like, 2015, 2016, that's going to be, like, really jarring. Like, it's gonna be hard to stick around when you don't feel the same attachment to the members you knew when you first started.
Yeah, I mean, I've gotten used to like everyone leaving, but as you said, I think NMB is sorely in lack in need of like something, a jolt. And I think just doing a massive like new gen push is what is necessary. Looking at this objectively, like say sorry to Miru, Nagisa, Akarin, Saipi, and just like push Ayan and Kohona in front.
Yeah.
I think that's but the only
they already seem like they're kind of winning in that direction.
I don't know, man. They always do that. Like back then, they would do that. Like, oh, they would like give you crumbs and say like, oh, we are gonna go for the next generation. But then next single, okay, Yamamoto Sayaka center.
Yeah.
Right. The thing is, like, Sayaka's presence is so big, and then Miru's presence is not that big. Right.
It's more of like very assumed. Like, if she's center, oh, that's cool, whatever, you know.
Yeah.
It's more surprising when she's not center, right?
With Sayaka, right?
Yeah.
Or are you talking about Miru? Sayaka.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, even meet her now these days, it's like not that surprising when she's center.
Yeah, it's not boring. The thing is, like, she's not as strong as Sayaka. I'm sorry to, for Miru fans listening to this. Hi to me. Yeah, but like, she's not as big as Sayaka, right? So it's not as offensive if she gets dropped from center.
Yeah, yeah.
Because like, even when Sayaka was dropped from center, like the three times that happened, you always like, everyone still recognizes that like Sayaka is there and Sayaka is still supposed to be center, and then she's just giving way.
Yeah.
Yeah, people were talking about how like when she was standing in the second row, she still like drew more attention than like Fumiru double center.
Yeah, remember like during Rashkunai, right? Because of the shadow center thing, people still, oh, well, Sayaka's still in the middle. Isn't she center?
Yeah.
Yeah, so, but then, like, I don't think Miru has that stature, and she shouldn't aim for that stature anyway. So, I think it's very, very imperative for NMB. Like, if they do the next single, I don't know. Maybe they're gonna do, like, a Yuuri Center graduation single.
Yeah, that's also, like, depending on, like, a few other factors. You know, when is she gonna graduate? You know, because, like, isn't there, like, like, I don't know, murmurings of it's supposed to be like this year or whatever.
Yeah, there's no official like announcement, but I'll give you a Takoyaki party exclusive and say that
she's oh, exclusive.
Yeah, she's gonna graduate by the end of the year, and she has said that to people in Handshake. She has never said it publicly, but yeah. Trust me on
which
this.
Which seems really soon, like, especially because, like, okay, well, that means what they, if they do a single, that's gonna probably be what, December, like last week of December, like they always do, which is really annoying.
Actually, if you look at the schedules, though, you will notice that the last Handshake event for Boko Ikaire, the new single, is November 3rd. It's really, really fast.
Yeah.
So if they wanted to, they could release a single mid to late in November.
November, yeah, or even. October.
And then she doesn't need to join the Handshakes anyway.
She could be like Milky or Sayaka.
Yeah, or Nana.
Wait, would we ever see her perform it at center then? Because if there's just like the music video, and there's no lives, and then she doesn't even like. Maybe her like
she can do a grad concert.
Oh yeah,
and, like any team in shows that are between then and that.
Yeah, and but like the grad concert, even she doesn't know yet, right?
Yeah, she doesn't know.
Like, it's like definitely not gonna be, you know, Sayaka Sonic level. It's,
yeah, no, no.
I'm that's like absurd. Predicting, you know, Oryx Hall, you know.
Me too.
Which is like
it would be nice if it was bigger, if it was like Kobe World, Moral, yeah, Kobe World or Osaka Joe Hall.
Yeah, but that's like Milky level.
Yeah, but realistically, like with NMB's current popularity, I think Oryx Hall is realistic.
The best thing to do.
Yeah,
which is kind of like where, like, you know, all the previous, you know, like, you know, Shu Fu.
Rainia,
Miori,
Miori, yeah. All the graduations happen in Oryx Hall.
That's like the graveyard. For,
it's a graveyard.
Yeah, yeah, Yuri's bigger Nana than is, Rainian, for sure.
Nana had hers at Budokan, actually.
Mm.
It's weird.
Wow.
Yeah. And then, yeah, Sayaka had hers in, like, the freaking World Expo.
Yeah.
It's no Kyocera Dome now.
Yeah, you know what like Kojirin says, keeps saying that I went to watch Kansai Collection, right? I don't know if we've talked about this. I went to watch Kansai Collection. Oh yeah, we did talk about this last time. So when NMB performed there, Kojirin like said like, oh hey, Kyocera Dome, I'm so happy to be able to perform here. Our goal is for NMB's 10th anniversary to be here in Kyocera Dome.
Huh.
Like, even then, I was like, huh, probably not
it's
happening.
It's nice to want things.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, so I have a different view on that. I think they've been letting the captains say that like they said it at the photo book release event. I think they're letting them say it so much they will make it happen. They might pull some shenanigans, like block off some seats or something like that. And like, we're technically in the Kyocera Dome.
So make a, like a super big stage where it takes up like a third of the arena, maybe. I don't know. I think it's like really, really unrealistic unless you say something like, oh, yeah, Yamamoto Sayaka and the rest of like all the graduated members are going to show up.
For 10th anniversary, which would be like a miracle. But actually, even if like Sayaka came back for Yuuri's grad concert, that would be amazing. But based on, I mean, I'll probably talk about this later, but just based on how Sayaka has kind of like all but abandoned NMB or any mention of it or tied to it.
I don't know. I don't think
it's going to happen.
Oh, okay. So I have another Takoyaki Party exclusive.
Oh, another exclusive.
No. So I know who Yuuri talked to about her graduation, which is... So during the day itself, the only members who knew that she was going to announce was Akarin, Kojirin, and Airi. And all of them have reasons. Is that Airi is like very close friends with Yuuri. So Yuuri told her. And then Kojirin is the NMB captain. So those two, Yuuri told them on the day itself. Right? So the only member who knew beforehand was Akarin. And because they're very close. But
when, also because she'd probably murder her on the stage if she
probably yes
freaking
yes.
pulls out like her like cosmetic like Wolverine claws.
I mean, Nagisa was crying really hard, like the angry kind of crying.
Yeah,
I like that.
So actually, during the next concert, she was saying Nagisa was joking about it, but even her joke was kind of serious, and she says like. like Nagisa was crying so much, right? When they actually like went off stage, she was like, she kind of threw a tantrum, and she's like, "Why does everybody just leave me?
Oh,
why does everyone graduate and leave me?"
Flashbacks to Nagishu.
Yeah. Yep. And like, so if you saw the stream, right, you could see like how much Nagisa was crying. Because Quintet. Anyways, so. I know
Akarin, right?
Yeah, Akarin knew. And then also...
but you said only from management.
Yeah, I don't know. So apparently, Akarin only found out from like high above from management and not even directly from Yuuri. But like we don't know like if Yuuri would have told her anyways.
Mm-hmm.
Because Akarin told Yuuri, say, "Hey, I heard that you're gonna graduate."
It's the worst way to find out.
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't think Akarin. So publicly, so this is very different from like how like Azusa quit. It's like because publicly the Quintet members are all very positive about it. Like obviously they're sad, right? But they didn't just like erase her name from the website or something. So that's kind of different.
Historical revision.
Yeah. So anyways, my point, going back to my point, was that Sayaka knew that Yuuri was gonna announce.
Hashtag Sayayuuri.
Yes, hashtag Sayayuuri.
Yeah. Yeah, so I guess I mentioned like this when we go talk about Quintet.
Yeah.
So it's probably, you're saying, yeah, it's probably, you know, a big problem for NMB, just, you know, NMB proper, but also Quintet. This is pretty much the end of Quintet.
Yes. Based on how Akarin talked about it, it's probably the end of Quintet.
Yeah.
But
rest in peace.
But Yuuri herself says that she doesn't know. Because technically, she could stay a part of Quintet even after she has graduated from NMB. Although, when I was... This was during my bargaining phase. So, it's like, well, she could stay in Quintet. And then Geoff decided to destroy it by saying, Well, if she's gonna stay in quintet, wouldn't she have to perform like AKB and NMB songs? It's like, which made total sense to me. It's like, oh yeah, fuck, she can't do that.
Yeah, I mean, she says she doesn't want to stay in doing this idly stuff. So
yeah, and it would be the same thing, right? No, like how I envision quintet would be like maybe there's just a grouping of girls, like how Johnny's does it. Like they sometimes do concerts, but not all the time.
Mm.
Right, and then they just get together for like tours and stuff. I don't know. So, but like the official word
or something.
Yeah, but the official word is that we don't know what's going to happen with quintet, but it does sound like it's the end based on because it's all Akarin, right? She's the one that keeps it together.
Yeah.
So I did have some conversations like with friends and stuff and say like if quintet did like a goodbye live, a goodbye concert, they could probably do Osaka Joe Hall.
I could see that.
Yeah.
Right. Rather than like Yuuri herself, like I don't think she can do Osaka Joe Hall.
Maybe after all four of them graduate and they announce like a reunion.
Quintet reunion.
Reunion tour. I could see it being like a two-part concert series. It's like 2 days or whatever. So one day is Quintet and then the other day is Yuuri
graduation. Oh, that would be nice.
That way you get a concert for the girls and concert for the not girls. Actually, you'll probably get like girls too, but
that would be good. Actually,
that'd be messed up. They do another like Osaka Joe Hall, but for Quintet, but it's girls only.
They wouldn't be able to fill it.
You have to go and drag.
Did we cover everything? It's the last one.
Yeah, I think, it's just a bunch of like question marks. Yeah, when is this? We don't know anything about concrete details, but we're hoping, you know. Satisfactory conclusion, I think.
There is no satisfactory conclusion. No, I'm joking about like being really, really sad and stuff. Like, I mean, I am, but I mean, it's been a while, so I have come to terms with it.
Acceptance.
It's been
phase.
A couple weeks.
Yeah, acceptance. I hope so. I don't know.
I
waver between like anger and denial.
I mean, now you're at the point where you just want to like go to every single event she's in and like enjoy it to the fullest, right?
Actually, to be honest, like I just want it to be over.
Yeah,
I mean, obviously,
that's
like,
true. I can see that.
I want to enjoy like all the
just rip
stuff,
off the band-aid.
Right? Yeah. I mean, I think the worst part about like graduation announcement is like when they don't tell you when she's gonna leave.
Yeah, like kind of like that dread, like okay, you make sure you take your days off, request your days off, you know.
Yeah, exactly. Like I can't plan for shit.
Yeah,
because they're gonna announce like a Wednesday concert or something. Then I'm gonna have to like scramble to like find a day off on that day.
Mm-hmm. Because of course it's gonna be a weekday.
Yeah, of course it's gonna be. So NMB, it's gonna be a weekday. So, like,
yeah.
I just like, and like for example, handshakes, right? You know that they have sold handshakes for her until February.
Yeah, that's why I was like when she first announced it before you even said like the whole like rumors about her. Oh, she's gonna be done by this year. It's like, oh, she'll, you know, she wouldn't do an AKB dirty, but she already did when she took.
She would. She doesn't like AKB.
Yeah. So I'm like, oh, she might be around. Also, because, like, hey, that give her more time to, like, okay, prepare, like, you know, a proper single, you know, goodbye single, a good proper goodbye concert and all that stuff.
Yeah.
If they push it to past February, but it seems like, that's not the case.
I mean, I asked her, like,
when I have tickets in February.
No, I told her, like, so when are you leaving? And she says, like, oh, well, I can't tell you the date. I say, can you tell me like how long are you gonna stay? Say like she's like, well, it depends on the person like how they feel if it's long or not, right? It's like, well, no, just what do you feel?
Just getting all like philosophical.
Yeah. It's like, well, I think it's gonna be she says futsu, which is like the normal amount of time.
Well, for like a big member or for like a theater girl, 100 yen chan.
Yeah. It's like a theater girl, so next month things. Is gone, right?
Yeah, hey, I went through that. Yeah. That's why I had to come through to terms with it real fast.
So a lot of people asked her about the coming of age day. Because she's going to be 20. Mm. She's going to be 20 and she's going to be wearing like the really, really nice kimono. The furisode. And then she has said like multiple times before that she really, really doesn't want to do that because it's really embarrassing.
This is really why she's graduating.
Yes. No. So a lot of people like asked her in handshake about that and she's like, no. I will not do like AKB stuff.
And Ryan's happy because now he doesn't have to get tickets for that.
It's no tickets. Like you have to like wait
in the Myojin overnight.
Yeah, you know why? It's a really, really small shrine and then people camp out in the middle of winter.
In January.
Yeah, so I'm kind of happy that I don't have to do that. I might literally die. I've done like way stupider stuff, but
like was it that Budokan, like was it like the benefit concert or whatever they did for like the earthquake, or was it Kobe? No, yeah.
Like, oh, the benefit one's really nice because it was in Kyocera Dome.
Yeah, but then you had to like wait like.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah. I stood in line from 5 a.m. to 1 p.m.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, and then so she said like, oh, you know, the normal amount of time, which is like okay, and then yeah, she wants to be an actress, and you know, I hope she does well. And then goodbye NMB.
Goodbye NMB.
Goodbye
Takoyaki
party.
Yes.
Thanks for listening. We'll see you never. No.
I don't know. I don't think. Like a lot of people ask me about like, oh, so what are you gonna do after? So, I don't
who are you gonna Oshi next?
No one. I'm telling you that. Rinachi.
Nah. Yeah, you're gonna go to Rinachi.
Nah. Nah. No. It's too much effort.
Yeah.
Do you know how long I've been following Yuuri?
We'll see if you can beat that with Rinachi.
That's not gonna happen.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm starting the Amimaru minute right now.
Hey, I didn't start it. You started it this time.
Yep. I have my stopwatch. It's going.
All right, Amimaru news break.
She got chosen to be like the reporter for the Kobe Marathon this year with Shinshin, same as last year.
Yeah.
So, go read the internet articles.
And now back to sports with Ryan.
No, you guys still got like 30 seconds.
Nah, never mind. Stop that.
All right. That's it. You don't get like cash in like the remaining time later in the show.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can. You're not the boss of me. You're just gonna cut the whole thing. I did agree to it being the Amimaru minute. I said it was the Amimaru watch.
Semantics.
Yeah. So back to Yuuri.
It's definitely going to be like a weird, like, we thought this is like the next chapter of NMB, which I mean, we still are, but this definitely is like a weird, like, left turn it took. Like, you know, it's like the Choose Your Own Adventure book.
Yeah.
And you turned to the page where you graduated. Like, oh crap! But as long as you don't let go of the page, you're okay, right?
So it was like your choice was like jump off the cliff or like go back to safety, and then you chose jump off a cliff. So now we're in the unknown.
I mean,
I am a strong proponent. I think the next single has to be Ayan and Kokona centered.
Yuuri Goodbye Center, or is that gonna
after
for
like,
ASI
the next
and then,
like real
Yuuri
the next real one.
Grad song
the next real one so okay. the
next
spring
real one.
the spring
you're implying
single.
The Yuuri grad isn't a real single.
It is like, it's just the graduation one. No, so I think the spring single is a good time as any to just do Kokona and Ayan.
Yeah.
New year, new beginnings.
Yeah. Or
rehash beginnings.
I even more, I do recommend that they just do a solo center for Riona.
Yes. I would be down for that.
I think Desperate Times. Yeah, Desperate Times call for desperate measures. Just do Riona Center. Or Amimaru Center, that would be better. No, I'm kidding.
But I mean, like, kind of, if you call it Choose Your Own Adventure, it's like, this is what NMB management chose with their approach of, like, keeping Sayaka center forever. And then
keeping Miru center.
Yeah. I wanted to say this a little earlier, but like when Yuuri said like, "Oh, I haven't wanted to be center for a while," when everyone else is expecting her to be, it's like,
yeah.
What kind of message is management sending to her, and also, an extension sending to other members?
Yeah,
it's like kind of like, bide your time. You know, your time will come. Once we exhaust our...
That's the thing, though. It never comes. Especially with NMB, yeah. It never comes.
Yeah.
And I remember, oh my god, I really, really, really remember when they announced Boko Ekaere. And then I was, so upset that, Yuuri wasn't center. And that was during Handshake. I even told her, I'm really disappointed that you're not center. And she's like, oh, I'm not. I'm
disappointed in you.
No.
And she's like, no, I'm not.
In hindsight, now you know.
Yeah. I mean, I thought that just meant she doesn't want to be center anymore, but I didn't realize that just meant that if I'm not going to be center, I'm going to leave.
Right.
Because I remember thinking that back then, I think I told you guys about this, is if you're not aiming to be center, then just quit. This what's the point? And people
a version of shoot for the moon. Even if you miss, you'll be among the stars. Shoot for the center, even if you miss, I guess
no, you'll still that's be, true. You'll be among that's true. No, that's true though. That's true though. For Kenkyuusei or whatever, what's the point of not aiming for center? You're so new, right? No one ever joins NMB and says oh, I want to be the seventh position. I want to be the edge of the second row. Right? Who does that?
Yeah.
Anju.
Right? So, should always aim to be the center, because why not? It's like Anju, right? When they ask her, what's your Sosenkyo target? She always says number one. It sounds, I mean, it is really funny, but it sounds stupid, right? But that's correct. Why not?
That's the correct answer.
Yeah.
And then there's always Kinoshita Momoka. There's no, don't vote for me, vote for Milky instead.
Yeah. It's I think this is really stupid, but I'm joining because they told me to join.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Momoka's, a character. But yeah. Yeah, I think. What do you guys think? Who do you want to be the next center? Why we are just assuming that it's not Miru, right? Because
she ruins everything, and it can't be Yuuri. Yeah,
I also hope they move on from Miru. Personally, I hope they stick with fifth gens because they've been pushed for a long time as well. It would be really weird just to skip them. And personally, I know fifth gen's much better now than D3 and sixth gen, so I'd like to see them get their time.
I think the only danger with the fifth gen, would get center or not, is that maybe if management just goes, okay, let's shake it up. And then they're going to be like, well, fifth gen has been here too long, so we're going to go with someone younger.
Yeah.
And they just do Horinochi Momoka Center or something. I hope they don't do that.
The only, yeah, and then like the other trap is they like stick with fifth gen for another 4 years because they're young enough.
Mm. Yes. Although I think that's the correct choice though, right now. I think that's the correct choice because they are young. Mm-hmm. And they have the, it's like, I mean, Kojirin's captain. So the weird thing is that you can see this with, and we should, if we get into the end converse, team end conversation, is that the weird thing is that now there's like basically two NMBs.
Yeah.
Like fifth gen down and then first to fourth.
Yeah. First like to D2, guard, I guess. New gen.
Yeah, the old guard and the new gen, right? Yeah. Because like, I think the gap was too much. It's like 2 year gap between gens.
They're basically completely different groups.
Yeah, yeah. So that's
one's
why
it's for like... the Lolicons, one's for the perverts. Even though one of the members of the Lolicons is also for the perverts.
Who?
Actually, two of the member two. Su-chan. Two of the Lolicons.
Su-chan and Ray-chan. Yeah, that's true.
Actually, Su-chan's not a Lolicon though. So, and actually, Ray-chan isn't anymore either. Not anymore.
Yeah, I think it's. It's gonna be a really challenging year for NMB. Like when we hit January 1st and Yuuri's not there, it's gonna be. I mean, I hope that it's the start of like the new look NMB, because you know for sure that like Akarin and Saipi and Nagisa are on their way out.
Yep. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Even like rest of like you know second gen, third gen.
Yeah, and you know why they're on their way out? Because they have careers outside of NMB.
Yeah.
And Yuuri has shown that you don't need to be an NMB if you want a career outside NMB. If you have a career outside NMB. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that was a ray of sunshine for everyone.
Or a rainbow that was made.
Can't have rainbows without rain.
I was making a nijiri. It was gonna cut that joke.
Hey, this is how you make a rainbow.
All right, we're gonna take a break time. Stay tuned for Ryan's graduation from Takoyaki Party. And we're back. There are no more members left in Team N.
Clearly, yeah.
Now that Yuuri is leaving.
Yes. She took everyone
with her. So Ryan's not going to go to any theater shows ever again. So.
Yes.
It's the end of NMB, right?
Yeah. Isn't it? Clearly, the end of NMB now.
No, there's hope. There's light at the end of the tunnel.
What? What do you mean?
Because they promoted not all, but some, a few, a handful.
Well, of the Kenkyuusei. They basically promoted like the top Kenkyuusei members. It's in the top
that aren't named Amimaru.
That aren't, yeah, of course. that goes without saying. Like Amimaru's like top. Now they promoted all the top. See, okay, they promoted all the top NMB Kenkyuusei. Well, Shinshin's not top, but she sells well and she's old, so I guess they promoted her too.
Hmm.
Because the current top four of Kenkyuusei is Otariona, Hasa, Anon, and Hoinochi Momoka. So this is literally the top four of Kenkyuusei. Guess who's number five?
Amimaru.
No, it's not Amimaru. She's like
Harakaren.
Cutie party. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yep. I'm gonna ask her next time what's the fall party? Cause I feel like Nasu. Cucumbers, that's only good for summer.
Kabocha party.
I'm thinking mushroom party. It sounds Kinoko like we party? Some drugs though.
Yeah. Well, it's phallic, like, right? It, it's a, it's she's potato. Talking she's talking about penises, right? Let's cut to the chase. She's talking about penises, yeah. right? So
yeah,
it has to be eggplants.
Eggplant
next.
Party, yeah. Natsu party, yeah. Anyway, speaking of eggplants, the promotions. We'll start to talk about the promotion members who went where. So Riona went to Team N.
Yeah.
Hasa went to Team N.
Yeah.
Anan went to Team N.
Yeah.
And then Horimomo went to Team M.
Yes.
And Shinshin with the B2.
Yes.
With the rest of the Lolicons.
Yeah, so the funny thing was that they got promoted during the Kobe concert. And in Kobe, only four of them were there. Riona, Hasa, Horimomo, and Shinshin. So Anon wasn't there. Apparently she was backstage watching. So I was telling Geoff, right? It's like when they promoted Anon in Sendai. So Anon was the only one promoted in Sendai. She was like, because at the end of the Kobe concert, Yumin posted a picture of Anon crying because she didn't get promoted. And then she gets promoted like a week later in Sendai. It's like, give me back my tears.
I was like, Yumin is like, why did I tweet that?
Rinachi in her Rinachi in her Mobame actually said that like she felt weird when Anon got promoted because she even had like a conversation with Anon about like, oh, we're the only ones left in Kenkyuusei. Let's try our best so we get promoted.
The only ones, but in like 10
of us. Not the only ones. I mean, like all the other like top members of Kenkyuusei got true. Promoted, right?
Rinachi's and then Rinachi's like border.
She's fifth. She's like the basically, if they don't change positions in Kenkyuusei, Rinachi's gonna be like number one. If there's no more promotions,
which there probably will be, I imagine that's what they're gonna be. That's gonna be the big announcement for 9th anniversary.
Really, I think it's gonna be a single.
They're gonna promote. They're gonna promote. Why not both? .gif. They gotta promote the 6D3.
I don't know though why. Because if you promote too much, then you can't do Kenkyuusei shows anymore. Not that they care, but
I guess it also kind of like undermine like this wave of promotions, right?
Yeah, exactly. So what's the point of promoting them early if they're gonna do another another set?
Yeah, I mean, because like 2 years ago at 7th anniversary, they decided to promote basically all the 5th gens, right?
Yeah. Yes. So that's why I was expecting like a repeat, but I think there's too many of them.
Yeah, it would feel exactly like that.
I don't like mass promotions. They also did it last time too. They also did it in 5th anniversary, I think, with Joe and her friends.
All the Sozo no Shijin
Kenkyuusei got promoted all the same time too. I don't know. I personally don't like that kind of promotion because you kind of take the spotlight away. Mm-hmm. Like for example, when Anon got promoted, right? She got like so much like love. Right? All the members were like hugging her, and then all the fans were like chanting her name.
Mm-hmm.
But if everyone gets promoted, it's not really special. I don't know. It's a personal preference.
For Sozo no Shijin, they still kind of have that whole Kenkyuusei bond. For the later groups, definitely not, though.
Yeah. Like, 5th gen... I guess 5th gen got promoted early. Did they?
Yeah.
They didn't stay Kenkyuusei for like very
less
long.
Than a year.
D2 was super long. Because D2 got promoted the same time as 5th gen, right?
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Like, Erdin was promoted.
Yeah. Like, Yuzuha and Momone and all those people.
Shout out to Nathan.
Yeah. So, Muranaka. Oh, wait, no, she got promoted earlier. I guess she got promoted earlier. for some reason. Anyways, not important. But yeah, I don't think they're gonna promote on 9th anniversary because, yeah, as Matt said, right, it's gonna be, why did you promote during the tour then? What the fuck?
Because we need to have announcements at every concert.
That's the thing that I dislike.
That's what, half the reason people are paying to go to these shows.
Yeah, I know. That's what pisses me off. Why are you...
The performances are second.
Like, if there's like no announcement... For example, like in Quintet Nagoya, there was no announcement. Like, and people were disappointed. And that kind of pissed me off. Like, I was disappointed too. But like, that pissed me off. Because... Why do we have to expect surprises?
Yeah.
Why can't we just enjoy the show for itself?
Yeah. Yeah, especially this tour set list is really good.
Yeah.
I wanted to just, like, go off on that high feeling.
Yeah, but then you have graduation. So, like, when they did Warukoko, right? Oh, that's pretty good, actually. That's for Matt. Did you watch Warukoko?
Yeah. Yeah, I did.
But that got, like, that didn't register with anyone. Like, a lot of people were like, oh my god, so cute, and they were so excited, right? But then it got, like, flooded with, like, all the Yuuri posts, and it didn't matter.
Yeah. Was that before or after Yuuri?
It was before. It was on the same concert.
Okay. That's what I meant. Like, I mean, what did... Is that part of the encore? I guess it's probably the typical pattern where someone announces bad news and then they do station lap time.
Yes, exactly.
It was exactly
that, Matt.
It's the only song hype enough to get you to like stop crying for a moment.
Oh my god, that was like the saddest station lap time for me. Like, it didn't...
Not even the Sayaka one?
It didn't register. No, not even. Because like, I don't know, like when they did... Oh, we have to have one more song, and then the final song is Seishun no Rap Time, and then, like, I don't know. I want to say that everyone is half-heartedly doing the mixes. Yeah.
Oh, you were cheering your heart out.
Yeah,
because you knew like your time to do Yuuri cheers is dwindling.
Yeah. And they did double encore in Nijinus Korikata.
Yeah.
That was really good. That was when I think it was Seishun no Rap Time when Nagisa was crying.
Yeah.
And then like Hasa was just bawling her eyes out behind.
Mm.
Anyways, enough about that. Yeah,
so that's the promotions.
Yeah.
Kenkyuusei.
What do we have to say about the promotions? I think it's...
I mean, we already said it.
What did you say?
No, I think it's... Obviously, N has lost the most members because they had... From the most recent shuffle, they had the oldest members, and they now a bunch of them have graduated.
Yeah. And I was telling...
Surprisingly, yeah. You have, like, three of the top former Kenkyuusei in N, whereas before, everyone was looking at B2 as, like, the new...
Yeah.
Like the fresh next fresh gen.
Yeah. I was telling Geoff that like a Team N as a concept was a good idea, except they didn't count on everyone quitting. So the idea was like...
I feel like that happens a lot.
Yeah, I know. Like the idea was that it would be like the older team, right? It would have like better performers and power, like strong members. But then they forgot that like, if you're an older member, that means that you're more likely to quit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it hasn't been pretty actually, like all with all the graduations.
Yeah, the positive out of this is like kind of Team N is kind of, you know, they have their stage is called N Pride. They're kind of, you know, showcasing we are, you know, the product of NMB. Like we're good at dancing and performing and MC. And then for these Kenkyuusei who get promoted into there, they will really like get, you know, what's the word? Like trained into that system as well. So they'll kind of be really good successors of that NMB like spirit.
Yeah, I can agree with that.
At least that's what, you know, that's what they'll try to do, like what Chihi will try to do as captain.
Okay, so let's move on from slightly, I guess, happy news, I guess? Yeah, I guess happy news to sad news.
Sad.
And that, and the sad news is the second, maybe for Geoff is like the most sad news, I don't know, is Kawaiian, the other inn, Kawaiian TV is being shut down or ending their service, which Kawaiian TV has like a internet, there's like satellite TV channel, right?
Yeah, it's premium cable. Yeah. It's like HBO it's like for idols for some reason.
Yeah. Yeah. Which, yeah, a lot of idol shows are on there, namely a lot of NMB shows.
Yeah, basically, because it's owned by Yoshimoto, so use NMB for everything.
Yeah.
But it has a Team H show, though.
Only the Kansai members.
Yeah, it's a Kansai show. Because we want to support Kansai.
But it has who's the gaining? The Miki. I hate them.
Yeah.
Miki, I hate them.
Oh, they're funny. The cat guy, right?
Wonder, is that the same one they always use? It's like the guy with the pink sweater.
No, different guy. Right.
No. Okay.
But yeah, anyway. So Kawaiian has like Yugata NMB, Yorugata NMB, Lokegata NMB, Pokpoku Hyake. Basically all the NMB TV shows. Chan. Yeah, all the 100 Yen Chan TV shows are going away.
Including the most important show. Shiran Bange.
Anchu show.
It's like the game show that like Anchu and then like Ayati and Yamarina, like they switch. And along with these other comedians and other random guests, they play like a game. And the only reason I watch this is because they also like simulcast it with YouTube. So.
But yeah, I mean, basically, NMB is lucky to have Yoshimoto with, like, YNN and Kawaiian giving, like, an outlet for some of these, like, theater girls, these lower-ranked members who otherwise would only, like, be in the theater or have nothing else to do. It gives them an opportunity to show their skills and their interests.
Yeah, it's a really big loss, and I don't know. I think they're gonna transfer some of the shows to the like the net stuff, like YNN or Osaka Channel, but obviously no guarantees with that.
It's only probably like the biggest of the big, so probably Yugata and Yorugata.
Yeah, so Yugata and Yorugata are the ones people really like.
Those are the AK bingos of NMB for people who aren't like well versed in the NMB TV shows.
Pretty much. They do like the physical gags too.
No, the AK bingo in NMB is Manabu-kun.
But there's too much edumacation in that.
Yeah. And you need subtitles. Seven subs.
Yeah. If you like the style, it's like Yorugata and Yugata is very fun. I actually like Yugata much better because the comedians are funny.
And you can actually go watch them record it live.
Yes, exactly. That's why people love it. There are people who go watch every week, every other week.
Yeah. So like with that, would they still? For like Yugata and Yorugata, like now that's done live or whatever. So would they still do even if like they didn't put it transferred over to the new station or whatever? Do you think they'd still do it live, just not have recordings of it, or? Or is like the TV show like the whole crutch of that?
Yeah. Right? So it's probably a really cheap. It probably is really cheap to produce. So. they might do it because they charge entrance. So there might be value in doing it, but I don't know. Without Kawaiian TV footing the bill, I don't know what's going to happen. I mean, I can imagine them just transferring it to YNN, right? Maybe there is value in doing that. But
yeah,
no announcements yet, though. Like, no one has said anything.
Yeah, I mean, they said like, yeah, these are all the shows that are affected by it, I guess.
Yeah.
But yeah, whether they're going or staying or whatever. Okay. So let's move on then to, I guess this is happy news. We're doing like the compliment sandwich, you know, we've got sad, happy news, sad news, even though I'm not sure if my cheese graduation was happy or sad. Anyway, so Geoff, I think, was paying attention to this, the singing contest that AKB is doing
for
all the groups. And some of the NMB members are doing it.
Yeah, I think something not like doing it. 10...
It's done.
It's done. Yeah. Something like 10 or 10 or 12 NMB members entered.
Mm-hmm.
And
Chihi was the only one from Team N. That's what I remember.
Yeah. So there was like last Thursday and Friday were like the preliminary rounds, I guess. And then they're moving on to the top 20 now. So we have two NMB members who are moving on. That's Yamasaki Amiru and Akashi Natsuko. So Amiru got second place last year.
And I think in the prelim, she was also second place.
Yeah.
Behind Okadanana.
Mm-hmm.
Okadanana's like so crazy though. So it's like, why is she so good at everything?
She's mini
such a Mary Sue.
Yeah. Self insert. The fuck?
Oh, wow.
No. Apparently, Yahagi Moeka's in there too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I saw some of the like the performers, like the clips of like the NMB members.
Yeah. I thought they did well. I don't think anyone like was embarrassing. Natsu didn't get into the top 20, but she got into the finals anyway because the producer really likes her. So, and he's talked about it before. He said like what motivated him to create this competition itself was because he sees someone like Natsu who's like really, really talented, can sing very, very well, and then there's nothing for her. And so he thought to himself like, I have to create something to give spotlight to like these other girls who are very talented but maybe are getting not featured in their teams. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he did it. He created the singing competition and he cheated to get Natsu in.
Yeah. So that's cool. Let's then move on to the next piece of news. This is also really hot. Some of it is hot. Some of it is lukewarm in terms of how recent it was done. So Yamamoto Sayaka, former NMB member, is back with another tour. So after finishing like her like national tour of going to a bunch of local live houses, she's back to doing semi-large scale stuff with a tour of ZEP. But this time she's only doing Tokyo and Namba. So,
isn't this FC only? It's a FC event, right? Or is it actually a concert?
I think right now it's only the application is fan club only.
Oh, but it's not limited to a fan club. So they will open it.
No. Oh, okay. Yeah, generally. I think the same thing with her birthday event they did in July. Same deal. So it was like,
oh, did they open that too?
But I think, yeah, I believe so.
Because someone told me that it was a FC-only event, so maybe they were mistaken.
I just remember, both that and this, like, they're both, regardless of fan club, like, you're only limited to one ticket per application.
Yeah.
Instead of the typical, like, two.
Yeah, so you can't even go in with a friend, right?
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Still, like, all standing, so it's still, like,
You can find your friend when you get inside.
Yeah. Anyway, the Zep Tokyo leg of the tour is going to be on November 5th and 6th, so 2 days. And then the Zep Namba part is November 19th and November 20th. Mm. So yeah, only Tokyo and Namba, which really, I mean, that's all you need. But yeah, no Nagoya, no Fukuoka, or
I mean, probably Hokkaido. those concerts, the ones she did last time, probably lost money.
Well, I think it wasn't like, I think the Sapporo one or whatever was, they had like day of tickets.
Yeah, yeah. Like, Sapporo is always a problem because it's so far away.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I think, I mean, all artists do this though, not just Sayaka. They just focus on Tokyo and Osaka because those are the biggest like population centers.
Mm-hmm. But I'm already put my foot down. I'm not gonna go.
Why?
Because it's all standing. I've been to enough Sayaka concerts and I know I don't like Sayaka concerts.
See, Matt, so I can say that because I was never like twice. I can say that because I was never like a fan of Sayaka. I mean, I liked Sayaka, but I wasn't like, you know, Sayaka Oshii or anything. But you can't say that. Me, you can't say that.
It means something. It means something now.
Yeah. I guess.
I mean,
we had this conversation before, right? Like, we like idol Sayaka, not necessarily singer-songwriter Sayaka.
And she's pretty much, like abandoned the whole idol background, kind of like, you know, killed it, buried the past.
Yeah.
Which I feel like it's kind of disappointing.
Yes. Like,
why would you like just abandon your roots like that? Because then also you look at, because it doesn't even mention it by name, you know, doesn't do any songs. Also, I'm not expecting her to do that stuff, but, you know, even just like some kind of acknowledgement, you know. Because whenever she does like her like interviews and shows and stuff, she just doesn't talk about NMB.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't.
Or, like,
life. That's clearly, I mean, you can tell like it's a management decision, right? Like, even in like articles about her and stuff like that, they never mention NMB, which is kind of nuts.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it is disappointing, but I don't really blame her. I mean, you can tell it's management decision. So,
yeah. And then like,
what can you do?
Yeah. And I think it's like, and not to like make this whole comparison thing, but considering I've gone to like, you know, post NMB Milky concerts, and I like those way more
because she's still basically an idol.
She's still doing idol stuff, yeah. And but also she at least also still acknowledges, you know, NMB and talks about.
That's a different though NMB. Because like Sayaka wants to get rid of the NMB association because she thinks it's a negative to her image, right?
Yeah, or it's holding her back or whatever.
Yeah, so Milky's the other way because like to be honest, right? She's not that popular anymore, so she's playing up the NMB connection so that like people will attach her name to it. So she will ride on to the popularity.
Yeah, and I mean, it's still weird though. Having even like when I had like the conversation with Joe, it's like, I mean, all Sayaka's fans and her fans because of NMB. So it's just the way that it's like.
Oh, yeah. Like they're pretending to be singer like rock fans, right? Yeah. Really I thought that was a good interview with Joe. I think he brought up some really good points, and like when he mentioned that, I was like, "Oh, yeah, you know what? That's true."
Yeah. Fuck Sayaka. No.
Cuz can you imagine how many of her fans right now are actual rock fans? I mean, probably not.
What's even the Venn diagram of that, right?
Yeah, the Venn diagram that's probably really small, right?
Rock fans, Sayaka fans. Yeah.
Although, the next piece of news.
Yeah, so concert that was announced like a few weeks ago. But this was announced just last night or Tuesday.
See, you're doing this too.
Tuesday, a Tuesday in the middle of September, in 2019, Sayaka had this like announcement. Oh, I'm gonna do a live stream on, you know, Line Live, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube,
yeah,
probably fucking like a Bama TV.
probably on Vine.
Your toaster was probably streaming. Anyway, it's like, oh, big announcement. And then, like, I don't know, Ryan's like more excited about it than I was. He's like, tell me what she says. Even I don't know what you're doing. Do you have work or something? I don't know.
No, I was playing Monster Hunter.
Oh, you could have had it in the background. That's what I was doing. Anyway, so Sayaka's big live stream announcement is she's going to put out her third single on November 20th, which is also a day of her tour. Which, that's three singles in 1 year.
Yeah, it's quite a lot, actually. They're like, milking this. She's
outpacing AKB.
And NMB, I guess, also. But... Oh my god, you're right!
Holy shit. I mean, if I want to be really mean, also 27, because they only had one single this year.
Yeah. Why did she release three singles?
She's a singer-songwriter. That's what she does. Oh. She writes songs and sings them.
Okay.
Anyway, not only that, but she's also, well, also part of that single is, I guess she mentioned that Kobayashi Takeshi is, I guess, producing a ballad. I'm not sure if that's like the A-side or just one of the coupling tracks. But...
Oh, okay, so this, I thought it was the A-side, no?
Maybe, I don't know.
Okay.
I would guess a ballad is a B-side.
No, it has to be an A-side.
Because she's artsy and not fun anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then the other surprise announcement was also she's going to release her third album.
Yeah, that was the bigger surprise to me. It's like, I'm doing a single. Oh, but I'm also doing an album. It's like, what? Just do one.
It's probably just going to be like, you know, a compilation of, which, I was going to say, yeah, is it going to be original songs or is it going to be a compilation of, you know, of the first three singles?
Because her last two albums were all original.
Yeah. So I could see it, but also it coming out like, you know, a month or a couple weeks after the third single will be kind of like cannibalize the third single.
Yeah,
like,
so why would you buy the third single? Why would you buy the third single if, like, the third single is going to be inside the album?
Yeah.
Well, for that, you would need, like, something special for the B-side. So then maybe that ballad is the special thing.
And she doesn't do, like, you know, handshake events or any kind of, like, you know, fan service stuff. So it's not like there being a reason to...
Yeah, she does nothing. Like, all the fan club events have nothing to do with CD sales. She's doing it legit.
Is there, like, limited edition goods?
Nope.
Like, limited editions?
Nope.
Just concert goods.
Yeah, you can buy concert goods, but have nothing to do with the CDs. So they're literally just selling her CDs as CDs.
Like, I mean, her previous albums is, like, if you pre-ordered the album, you'd get, like, an entry into her tour... Yeah, lottery.
But they're not even doing that now.
Oh, wow.
Oh, you never know. She might announce another national tour next year.
Yeah. But, yeah, that's cool stuff for Sayaka.
Yeah.
Glad she's still doing stuff, even though it's stuff I don't like.
It's okay. She's going to be reunited with Yuuri soon.
in the idol afterlife.
In the afterlife, yeah. We'll see. Anyway. Okay, so that's it for the news. You know, it's running a bit long. We had some event reports talking about the concerts, but we kind of already kind of touched on them briefly. Maybe we'll go into it more next time, if there is a next time.
It's going to be part of the 9th anniversary conversation, I guess.
Yeah, I guess that makes more sense. Because, like, hey, we just like talk about the whole tour as a...
Yeah, in this Takoyaki Party episode that won't exist anymore.
Yeah. Spin-off one.
It's the cutie party.
The cutie party.
Yeah.
Starring Matt and Harukana. I'm going to like get some video messages and just, you know, play them, like, cut, splice them up in small pieces so it sounds like the full conversation.
Speech synthesizer.
Yeah. Anyway. So anyway, we're going to move on to the listener corner. So, yeah, just... based off comments and questions we got on our YouTube page where you can listen to this podcast. So this first one comes from Suzu. I'm not sure if it's Yamada Suzu.
Thank you for your comment, Suzu.
Anyway, it says, yo, any idea why Mikanyan went inactive on Twitter?
Yes. It's because people... She... she's very, very similar to like Riripon or like Nakairika. Like, you think like she's one of those like, you know, crazy like members who just say outlandish stuff. But I guess like people were saying mean things about her on Twitter, and she's like, yeah, fuck you guys. Peace out. And that was it.
I don't see that. But I went and checked her Twitter page to see, hey, if it was inactive or if it's been, because this post was commonly posted, like, you know, a few weeks ago, so maybe it changed. But yeah. Her last, like, so like the last thing on her, most recent thing on her Twitter page is a retweet of NMB page from August 8th, advertising the handshake sales or whatever. And yeah. The last original one was also advertising it, but it was posted by her. And this is the thing that made me actually made me kind of like jump up in my interest suddenly now. It's a picture of her like wearing a BlizzCon t-shirt. I'm like, what?
What?
She's going double.
Yeah, I think I've seen that.
BlizzCon t-shirt. I'm like, what? How? Why?
Someone must have just sent her one.
Or like she found it just randomly. Because, you know, you find like random like.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Maybe she found it in like those places that Yuuri buys her stuff. the secondhand shops.
Yeah, it's like, how did I even get in Japan? That's like my question.
Like some white guy sold it.
Anyway, that's what, that just made me really funny. I'm like, do you know what that is? I just want to go ask her. Probably doesn't know. I was like, oh yeah, I play StarCraft. I'm freaking diamond.
Well, that'll really get you.
Right. That'll get me on the board. That'll put me from not liking Mikana to putting her in the like category. Should be a real gamer.
Yeah, I like Mikana. She's really pretty.
She just looks weird. Anyway, yeah, so that's the story about Mikana. She's
a gamer.
Gamer. Confirmed. You heard it here first. Also, she doesn't like talk to people on Twitter.
Yeah.
So it's all you guys' fault. Stop harassing. Leave Mikana alone.
Yeah.
Anyway. Next part. This question, this comment comes from Jerris Generation. So he's responding to, like, when we talked about the our favorite music videos from the box set. Uh-huh. So he says his favorite music video is Kamonegix because it shows that the name of the song is a spaceship. It's a very electronic song, and he being mesmerized by Sayaka Yamamoto.
Yeah, I like Kamonegix, actually. I like the remix version much better, though.
It's on the album.
Yeah, yeah. Remocon Remix, I think it's called.
Yeah.
And the performance of that is like, oh my god, so awesome. You should watch that. It's really old now, though.
Wait, when did they perform it?
2013, Saitama Super Arena.
Oh, wow.
Damn.
Yeah.
And one of the big, like, the 48 group concerts?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Harukon or something?
Yeah, it was Harukon, and it was NMB Tandoku. So NMB only
Saitama Super Arena. Man, back in the day.
Yeah, each group did that at their own.
Yeah, yeah.
Solo ones.
Yeah, it was really good.
I think I went to the SKE one.
Traitor.
Because just before I changed jobs to where I could go to like concerts and events more freely, and that one just happened to be like on one of my days off. I was desperate for any kind of 48 concert. Good or bad.
Yeah, because I think their concert was like on a Friday.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. NMB was Saturday. I remember this.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think Joe has talked about that Kamonegix performance even on Takoyaki Party. Like an old Takoyaki Party. But yeah, it's
original OG.
Yeah, the OG Takoyaki Party. Yeah, it's really good.
It's like Doctor Who, like the 1950s era.
Yeah, classic Who. So the classic Takoyaki Party. Yeah.
Yeah.
Actually, one of the
I like that song.
One of the first images I ever saw of NMB was like, it was on a different forum, but someone had a GIF of the dance, the part of the dance where they're all lined up and doing that weird arm movement thing. It looks kind of like a Egyptian arm movement.
NMB really likes those, like the synchro stuff.
Yeah, I thought it was really weird though. It's like, why are they wearing these like silver?
Yeah, I actually don't like outfits. The Kamonegix costumes. I like the one that they changed to the combination with the Ha costume. That was really good.
It took me a while. Like, I was a bit late to realizing the Kamonegi, because they had like the picture of the duck in the negi. I'm like, oh,
yeah,
that's what it is. Also, fun fact: Kamonegix. Kamonegix is the Japanese name of Farfetch'd.
Oh, yeah. No.
Well, I mean, Kamonegi. comes from a proverb. Right.
Yeah. It's a duck with a spring onion.
It means like something really easy.
Yeah, I don't know the exact one, but yeah.
Yeah.
It's like a duck brings a leek with you and ready. It's like, please make me into soup.
That's why Farfetch'd is the most delicious Pokemon. All right, and then this last comment, it's more not what was posted on our YouTube, but I got it from lurking, the No AKB No Life Discord, and that is a conversation that's happened amongst a few members in that Discord, and it was talking about like, oh, this member's really weird. I think they're talking about like Nagisa and how she's like talking to a fire extinguisher.
Oh, that was really recent.
Yeah. Like a couple days ago, a week ago. Anyway, so this conversation came up, and it's like, who is the weirdest NMB member? And then on the inverse, is who is the least weirdest NMB member?
That one's
which
easy.
Is implying that there is not a normal NMB member. All the members are weird. I think it's pretty true.
I don't know. Like it's hard. Unique. It's hard to like give like a specific one answer because like. Yeah. The name that like pops into your head at first is gonna be like Rena Pion or something, right?
I was gonna say top three, which I guess might be also my top three also.
Just like weird girls then,
like Anchu, Nagisa.
I wouldn't say. Well, go ahead with your third.
I'm gonna say Harukan.
Yeah,
maybe. I don't think Nagisa's weird though.
Yeah, Nagisa's not weird. She just knows how to play up like really silly, cute comedy.
Yeah,
that's her style.
I think she's smart. Yeah. I think she's really smart. Yeah, I would agree with Anchu and Harukan actually. Like Harukan's like, oh my god, like a different planet from a different planet, basically. I don't know, and the thing with Harukan is like, I don't know how much of it is fake and how much of it is actually her being like
a
weirdo.
Like it's fake,
right? There has been a level.
Like she seemed like she should be like, you know, like Akarin style, like, you know, yeah, exactly. Like fashionable fashion model shit.
The thing is though, if you look like Harukan, why do you need to act like you're fucking 5 years old?
Exactly.
So it might be real. I think like Miki is like one of the weirdest.
Yes.
Yeah, I think my answer is Miki. Oh my god.
Definitely weirdest fans.
Oh yeah, oh my god. So if you've never been to a NMB handshake, go to an NMB event around the time that Miki is doing handshakes because you will see something you've never seen before in your life. It's like
a freak show.
Around maybe like 10 old dudes wearing like deer mascot hats.
Oh, the one from Nara?
Yeah, the ones you can buy there.
Oh, jeez. That's like the creepiest mascot.
Yeah, I remember someone. Oh, it's not the Sentokun one. It looks like an actual deer.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the Sentokun would be even worse.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Shikamaru.
Fucking will give you nightmares. I remember like reading something about a report. Like this guy went to Miki's lane and he was talking to like the weirdos, right, with the deers. And then he was saying, oh, I kind of feel embarrassed because all of you guys are wearing deer and I'm not. Then one guy just like pulls out like from his bag, like a hat. It's like, oh yeah, you can wear this. So, yes,
initiation.
I mean, her fans are weird, but then the weirdness from her fans comes from her being like space cadet, basically. Like, I don't know. Like, if you speak Japanese and you listen to her talk, you will doubt whether you speak Japanese. It's like, did she just say no? So yeah, Miki, I guess. And you know, she doesn't do Twitter because she's afraid of being hacked, apparently.
It's like, oh, I'm afraid my phone bill is gonna go up if I use Twitter.
Yeah, something like that. She's just like, oh, I don't know how to use it. It's like, well, I think some member was like, well, I'll teach you. So, okay. And she still doesn't have a Twitter. It's like how Momoka never bought a smartphone. She's always had like a Galake. Mm-hmm. And like someone would, like, management sends like the schedules, right? And then I guess the mail is too long for Galake. So it gets cut off. Mm-hmm. So she doesn't know her schedule, so her manager actually has to call her and tell her, hey, you have work tomorrow.
I'm surprised they didn't fax it to her, because, you know, Japan loves their fax machines.
Maybe they do. But, yeah. Miki's, yeah. Oh my god, Miki. And, like, one of the biggest, like, mysteries in NMBU is why Miki has not yet quit.
I always forget that she hasn't quit. Every time I see her.
Right? It's like, clearly management dislikes her. They'd give her nothing. She has no work other than like the occasional theater show. And no one knows anything about her. Like,
she's literally, she has no friends. From Yugata NMB.
Yeah, she got banned. Well, that's kind of a joke. She got banned from Yugata NMB. She's so weird. Like, she has no friends. No one knows what she does. Like, not even her own fans. Like, what do you do on your off day?
Members say they've never seen her eat.
See, like, she could have, like, this whole underground life that she's leading and no one knows. But yeah, so my answer is Miki. What about you, Geoff?
Is that
he okay? Man. Yeah, it's hard, like, Matt. Because too many unique members, but I can tell you the least weird.
Okay.
Ayan.
Yeah. That's why she's so boring.
Hey, she's my pick for next NMB Center.
Because she's the safe choice.
Yes.
Yeah.
And you know she's not going to fuck up. That's my position.
But yeah, that's probably my pick for the least weird too.
Yeah, me too, actually. Probably Ayan. She does everything by the book. Like, she there's probably like a manual on how to be an idol, and she just like follows it. She has like highlights on it, and then all these post-its.
Uses like that red like. Memory file thing.
Oh, yeah.
Cover up the answers. So she can memorize them.
Yeah. She has flashcards and stuff.
I want to see her Anki dick.
She probably says something like, smile into the mirror 10 times every morning.
Did I talk about tapioca today? I don't know. Did I take a selfie in front of a tapioca?
Yeah, go to a cafe today. Yeah. I think we're too hard on Ayan. I've come around to her. I think she's good. Should be the next Quintet member. After Quintet disbands.
It's just gonna be her alone.
Yeah.
Like, where is everyone?
It's the gif of Milhouse playing in the park.
But yeah, it's like, what? Yeah, it's like hard to think of like what members are not weird.
Because
they're all kind of weird.
Saipi.
Naru is probably one of my picks.
Yeah, Naru's a space cadet.
She literally cannot taste spice from like ghost pepper.
Oh my god! Like, you should watch. People listening to this, you should look up the Genkai Toppa episode where they made her eat. I don't know, crazy. Like, she can go on hot ones and like do not and like not affect her anything. Like, they were making her eat drink like Tabasco, and she was like nothing. And it's not really spicy.
It's like she doesn't on her show like Amakara-san. It's like she doesn't even know what spice is. Like, she, when she eats something super spicy that makes other members cry, she's like, what? I taste something. It tastes really good.
Yeah. Yeah, you can say like she's so dumb she doesn't even know what spice is.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, Chihi's probably not weird.
She has weird...
She looks weird.
Fighting words, Matt. Fighting words.
Yeah, her eyes have like that, like her... that deer in the headlight look all constantly.
Her eyes are going to fall out.
Yeah, it's too big.
No, So actually, her personality, she said it herself. She's like very contrarian. She also has like no filter. Or like sometimes she... With like members, she's... close to, she has no filter. Like, she will like make, she used to make fun of Iso-chan all the time on their radio show together.
Hey, that's what got bad.
That's what got me to like her.
Oh.
But she said she used to, I read some like old interviews, she said like she used to like at handshake events, if someone said, oh, like do some, say something really cute, and then she would be like, no, I don't want to. Because it was
sounds like Yuuri.
Yeah.
So, and NMB has a lot of characters, so you should all look for your NMB Oshis.
Yep, that's good. That's a good takeaway.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. So, I think that's gonna do it for this show. Our conversations about Yuuri and some of the other news topics, by all means, let us know what you think and share your opinions on the YouTube page comment. And we'll read that. You can also hit us up on Twitter, respond to that page where I post that thing, or tweet at us. And yeah, thanks for listening.